grab a notebook, grab a pen. Do your homework and tell a friend. Know all the answers and buzz them in. Who knows it better, you or them? It's the cooking classroom, now let's begin.
Now, here's the host of the classroom, Richard Curtis.
You ready to do this thing? Let's start the wave up. Let's roll, baby. All right, come on, here we go, Julia, Michael, let's rock it. Teachers, are you ready? They're feeling it, and they should be. Welcome into the show, everybody, today. It's our students. You guys ready to gear it up for this?
Yeah.
And our teachers, they're saying they already got it in the bag. Where are they from? It's the exceptional Timber Creek Regional High School in Camden County, New Jersey. Today, though, they're in my classroom. The show that pits students against their all-time favorite teachers. Hey, can you believe this crowd? They showed up in a bus today. They rolled in 100 strong, and I'm glad they're here because on the line today is $500 and these students right here to say that I'm smarter than my teachers. Can they get it done? We're starting with a pop quiz to find out.
Grab your buzzers. We have 1 minute and 30 seconds on the clock. Each correct answer will be worth 10 points. If you buzz in first, wait until your name is called to answer. If you get the question wrong, a contestant from the other team can buzz in and will have a chance to steal.
You heard the game, and the time starts right now. Pop quiz, guys. Good luck. A standard round of golf consists of how many holes? Here we go. Mrs. Hole.
18.
Get out of town with that. Good work. Vanellope von Schweetz most recently appears in what 2018 movie? Julia.
Ralph Breaks the Internet.
Yeah, great flick, by the way. In chemistry, homogeneous and heterogeneous are two types of what? Sierra.
Mixtures.
Yeah, nicely done. Back-to-back students. In Mary Rogers' book, Freaky Friday, 13-year-old Annabelle switches body with what family member? Julia.
Her mom.
Her Maja, absolutely. Any type of clock that indicates time by the position of rotating hands is called what? Julia.
An analog clock.
Yeah, look at you, a little bit on fire over there. What is the first and last name of the first winner of American Idol? Mr. Kozak.
Kelly Clarkson.
Yeah, there it was. Ooh, Sierra jumping the gun over there. Buzz and slap are examples of what type of word that imitates a sound? Michael.
Automatopoeia.
Yeah, you sound good saying that too. Good work. What year did World War I begin? Nobody. 14. Oh, here we go. Miss Dressel.
1914.
Work well done there at the end. Extra credit question. This one's worth double. 20 points on the line. Benedict Cumberbatch is known as what Marvel superhero? Mr. Kozak.
Dr. Strange.
Dr. Strange. Dr. Stephen Strange. You want to get more specific. What is the capital of Missouri? Tough question. Here we go. Nobody buzzed in time. We're looking for Jefferson City. That's going to break it down for pop quiz. How about a teacher's 50? Students 50! That's how you win this thing. You get your points up. Well, everyone's head-to-head right now. $500 is going to someone today. Michael, you might as well decide where it's going to go. You're the team captain for the students, yep. So what are you thinking?
Well, if we win, it's going to Aim High, which is a student scholarship program in honor of a former student to raise awareness for domestic violence.
That's awesome. I love where you're putting the money. We got the Aim High shirt on Julia today, too. So we're looking good. That money's going to go a long way. Cool. Mrs. Hole, how about you getting the 18 holes question right? The chances are...
My husband's very proud right now.
Yeah, he's happy. 500 if you win it, where's it going to go?
To be the James Club. It's used to promote kindness and respect through different activities and events.
That's perfect. And I'll tell you what, there's one school that you guys always seem to resonate is just positivity, which is weird because now you're going to send each other to detention. All right, teams, put your buzzers down. You guys aren't gonna need them here. You're gonna work together on this one. This is how detention works. Since the game is tied, students, we're gonna start with you today. We're gonna give you all a category. As a team, you're gonna have 10 seconds to decide whether you wanna play, if you wanna pass it over the teachers. If you choose to play, you answer the question correctly. You can send any teacher into detention, but if you get it wrong, the other team's gonna get to send one of you. You pass, they have to answer the question. Same elimination rules apply. You get everyone into detention. 40 points gets added to your score. Somebody's going to take that 90-50 lead right here. Let's play. Students, we're going to start with you guys. Here is your category. Space.
Yeah.
All right. What is the scientific term for a large eruption of an electromagnetic radiation from the sun, usually associated with sunspots?
A solar flare?
Solar flare, yeah, okay. You strike first, good work, guys. You get to send one of your teachers into detention now. Man, I love the strategy. They immediately start talking.
Miss Hole.
Miss Hole, our team captain, out of there. She's our counselor of 6 years. But today, she's a detention of one. Get comfortable, Mrs. Hole. There we go. Teachers, we go back to you. Mr. Kozak, Mrs. Dressel. Category is geography.
Just play it.
Here we go. I love that attitude. Let's just play it. How many countries make up the United Kingdom?
Four. I'm sorry. Should we have questions?
Yeah.
Four.
Mr. Kozak's like, man, what about me? I could play two.
Four.
Four is right. You guys get the points. How about it? England, Scotland, Wales, and my favorite, Northern Ireland. You guys got to go. But that's going to get one of those students into detention. So who's that going to be? Mrs. Dressel, did you want to let Mr. Kozak play at all? Or maybe he gets to pick the student.
I'm so confident.
All right, you pick who goes in.
We're going to send Michael to detention.
All right, Michael, our team captain. There he is, guys. A senior in high school. He's going computer engineering next year. Figure out a way to computer your way out of detention. Students, category, math.
We'll play it.
The number 6 is a positive integer that is equal to the sum of its proper divisors, 1, 2, and 3, which makes it what type of number?
Regular.
Answer, guys?
Regular number.
Let me check with the judges. No, guys, that's incorrect. We're looking for the perfect number. That's a perfect number. Okay. Did you say it?
No.
Oh, okay, perfect. Okay, guys, perfect number. Not going to get it done. Teachers, you get to send another student to detention. Who's it going to be?
We're gonna send Sierra.
Sierra, leaving Julia by herself to defend the students in detention. Okay, Sierra's comfortable over there, and we move over to our teachers. Category is special events. Pass or play?
We'll play.
What Philadelphia New Year's Day tradition involves groups in colorful costumes strutting down Broad Street?
The Mummers Parade.
The Mummers Parade is right. Teachers are gonna win detention. Julia, you have to go to detention. Mrs. Hull, you are officially released. You can come back to the squad, and you should, because we got to celebrate. They just got 40 points for their team, bringing you guys up to 90. Now, when we come back, we're gonna put some pens and paper in their hand, because we're going to art class. What's up? Welcome back to the classroom. Look at the vibe in this front row, guys. I'm telling you, it should be huge because it's the students and teachers from Timber Creek Regional High School in New Jersey. I'm telling you, these guys are the best Chargers team that I know of. You've been rocking at school. How's everything been?
It's been good.
Yeah, so we're back. This guy and me had a big first season because they've been on the show already once. Teachers remained victorious, and I said if you ever came back, you'd get a big one of these. Let's meet our teams. Mwah!
Hi, I'm Michael Tease. I'm the senior class president, and I just came back from Spain to win this game.
Hi, I'm Julia. I'm a junior. Usually I'm killing it on the field hockey field, but today I'm here to woe the competition.
Hi, I'm Sierra, DECA president and class of 2021 officer, and I just got my braces off.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Holt. I'm a school counselor. I'm here to make my boys proud. Hi, Michael and Marco, and to defend our teacher title.
Hi, I'm Mr. Kozak. I'm a ceramics teacher. Normally I throw pottery, but today I'm ready to throw down.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Dressel. I teach special ed and Spanish. Buenas suertes, muchachos.
How about those teams going head to head? Guys, let's put some markers in hand. We're going to art class, baby. Here's the Here's how this game works. Each team selected one player to draw on this board. The trailing team's gonna go first, so I got Sierra up here with me. She's gonna select a card with a word or phrase hidden on the inside. She's gonna have 5 seconds to draw. Then her teammates will have 10 seconds to talk and make one guess. Correct answer is gonna be worth 30 points. If you guess incorrectly, I'm gonna give you a couple more chances, but the points decrease with each round we play. Here's the question though. Are you a red card or a blue card kind of gal?
Feeling like blue today.
Blue's gonna do it. You come back here, you stand right there, and you can check out your word.
Okay.
Michael, Julia, you don't do anything besides keep smiling there for a second as she has the card and she has her idea. Uncap your pen. You have 5 seconds when I say go. Nope, right here. She's like, I'm out of here. 5 seconds. Starts right now. Okay, good idea. Okay, stop. I like this. Could be it, guys. You can get this now. You have 10 seconds, one guess. Good luck. Talk about it.
Camera? Maybe.
Okay. Is it a camera?
Not a camera? Okay, we go to round two. You're gonna have 5 more seconds, Sierra.
Okay.
And we're down to 20 points this round. Let's see if you can get it done. Here we go. 5 seconds starts right now. She's adding on to the original. Stop. Wow, 5 seconds flies. Good luck. Michael and Julia, what are we looking at?
Is it an oven?
Not an oven, okay. But I like the thought process. You're gonna have 10 seconds to finish this up. You can start a new picture, you can go on the old. You have 10 seconds to get this done. Here we go. Your time starts right now. Mike, Julie, just to give you a heads up, she's gone off the rails here. She started something completely new. Here we go. For 10 points, good luck. Did she draw the same picture over again?
I think she did. Yeah, maybe, I don't know.
Is it like ice cream sundae?
Not an ice cream sundae. Sierra, you wanna tell them what it is?
It was supposed to be treasure.
Treasure! We were looking for the map there, couldn't get it done. No points awarded. Give her a big hand though, okay, for trying. As we bring our teachers up, Mr. Kozak is our drawer today. He calls himself the Kozakinator at school. Have you ever done this before? Good luck.
Not this fast.
All right, well, you're gonna be okay today. 5 seconds is all you're gonna get.
Okay.
Okay? You guys ready?
Yeah.
5 seconds starts right now. Kozak is a ceramics teacher. All right, stop. Could that help him? 10 seconds, guys. Good luck.
Is it a robot?
A robot it is, and 30 points gets added to your score. Wow, that brings the teachers up to 120 points for the game. Students up to 50, but we're not going anywhere yet because I'm a nice guy. I'm giving somebody some extra credit. Okay, I'm gonna ask one extra credit question. Both teams have 1 minute during the commercial to write down their answers. Correct points, 10 points. Here you go. Here's your question, guys. The constellation Leo is depicted as what animal? Ooh, good luck. Do you know the answer at home? I hope you do. We'll have it for you when we come back. Good game. That's the best rug in show business right there. Welcome back to the classroom. Today we have students and teachers from Timber Creek Regional High School in Camden County going head to head. Scores, teachers 120, students 50. We had some extra credit on the line. Here was your question. The constellation Leo is depicted as what animal? Each correct answer, 10 points. Michael, Julia, you said?
Lion.
Lion. Our teachers, Mrs. Holt, you said?
Lion.
10 points both sides, 120, 60, 130. Let's do this thing. This game is firing on all cylinders. Grab your buzzers, guys, because you're gonna need them right here. Oh, I love me some music class, guys. Grab your buzzers. Today's music class is testing your knowledge of song lyrics. I'm gonna ask a question related to a popular song, guys. Then Mike Jerick from Fox 29's Good Day Philadelphia will read a small portion of the lyrics. And my man is a good singer. The first person to buzz in and correctly answer my question will win 10 points for their team. If you buzz in, you get it incorrect. The other side can still buzz in and steal those points. We have 3 sets of lyrics today. Here we go. Let's ask the question. What female performer sings these lyrics in a 2017 hit collaboration? Ladies and gentlemen, I give to you Mike Jerick.
I hope we can get through this because I'm a little tired. Because I've been running through the jungle. I've been running with the wolves. To get to you.
Who are you getting to?
Selena Gomez.
Wolves, that's right, good job. Okay, Mike, you were a little tired there, I get it, but Sierra just nailed that question. Mike, you know you have a second one ready to go for you. Let's see how you do here. What rapper sings these lyrics in his 2010 hit song?
Here goes number two. You know what it is. Black and yellow.
Sierra again, first one in.
Wiz Khalifa.
Yeah. Called, oddly enough, Black and Yellow. So there it goes. All right, guys, moving into question three. Here's your question. Grand finale. What band sings these lyrics in a 2018 song? Mike, finish it up strong.
Everything's coming up aces, aces. If it's a dream, don't wake me, don't wake me. I said, hey, look, Ma, I made it.
Buzzer, stay silent. Julia, under the gun.
Is it Panic at the Disco?
Panic at the Disco! Woo! You feel that? You got that with 0.2 seconds left on the clock before the buzz. Great job. Hey, speaking of great job, Mike, thank you for doing that, sir. You're excellent. Scores, teachers, 130. Students just swept the round, 90 points on the board. It's anybody's game, and we're done this game. So let's call it final exam time. The all-important final exam topic. It's money talks, people. This means all the questions have to do with currency, something that I'm sure the students have no idea about yet. I'm gonna ask both teams three questions about our final exam topic. Each correct answer is gonna gank them 100 points for their team, possible 300 left on the board. You guys will write down your answers during the commercial break. But first, let's just get to the questions. Here they are, this will decide the game. During the Civil War, what was the colorful name for the paper money printed by the Union government to help finance the war? Question two, money talks. Bottle caps from Nuka-Cola are used as currency in what video game franchise? I've played way too many hours of that. Finally, what is the term for fake or fraudulent currency of any denomination that is forged to look like the real thing? There are your questions, three of them, 300 points left for these guys to grab. 60 seconds on the clock. Smiles right now could turn to tears later because someone's getting crowned champion of the classroom. Will it be the students? Will it be the teachers? We're gonna find out after this short commercial break. But you, ladies and gentlemen, have an opportunity to play this game. Here's how you can do it.
Does your school want to be part of a game show pitting students against teachers? If you're a principal or an authorized school official, go to theclassroom.com for more information on how to get on the show.
Welcome back into the classroom. Today, it's students, teachers from Timber Creek High School going head-to-head. Teachers, 130 on the board, and I'm pretty sure I just caught Mrs. Dressel going, you guys stink, mouth that across the studio. That did just happen to the students, 90. Look, someone's gonna win this thing. The topic to figure it all out is money talks. Three questions on the line. Each correct answer is gonna bank you guys 100 points. Let's get right into it. You guys like final exams come semester time, right?
Love them.
Yeah, okay. I was going, nope, I'm a senior, not a chance. Here we go, guys. During the Civil War, what was the colorful name for the paper money printed by the Union government to help finance the war? Students, you got 90 points on the board. You've played a great game today. Sierra, let's see what you said.
We have no idea, Richard, but go TC.
Love that. Okay. Good use of time on the camera there. Love that, Sierra. No points awarded. We move to the teachers. Mrs. Dressel.
It's gonna happen here too, but at least we pretend that we knew.
Green.
Green and go Timber Creek. Yeah, you were halfway there. We were looking, if you added backs there, you would have had it. Green backs, yeah. Not gonna get you guys any points on either side. We stay 130 to 90. We move to question two. Bottle caps from Nuka-Cola are used as currency in what video game franchise? Julia, this is one of my favorites. I hope you get this right. What did you say?
Fortnite.
You didn't get it right, Julia. No, ma'am, we are not looking for Fortnite, but I'm gonna tell you, you did have a letter correct there. Mr. Kozak, what did you say?
Call of Duty.
Also incorrect. Audience, I heard someone say it out there. The answer was Fallout, guys. Fallout, one of my favorite franchises on there. And how about this one? 130 to 90, students versus their teachers. And the show comes down to this question. Here we go, guys, good luck. What is the term for fake or fraudulent currency of any denomination that is forged to look like the real thing? Students, you have to get this right or the game is over. Michael, you're a senior. You're gonna study computer engineering next year. That could have helped you with this question. What did you say?
We said counterfeit.
You keep the game alive and take the lead for now. Teachers, Ms. Holup, you said counterfeit. This game is over. $500 goes to you and to a great fund on the teacher side.
I don't know.
What did you say for the win on the classroom and back-to-back Timber Creek teacher wins over the student? You said
counterfeit.
Counterfeit and counted. Teachers are two-time reigning classroom champions, and they're taking home $500. But either way, they had a great game today. And thank you guys for joining us. We'll see you next time with a brand new school right here on the classroom. I thought you guys had them right there, man. I thought you guys could pull it off, especially the redemption. We had to get the students to come back.
Next year,
season three, baby. Look, the good news is they still like you guys. So you still get recess or free time, whatever you still get.